aggressive with these fucking hooker cards, and this guy's flipping off the back of the camera. People are really fucking stupid in the world, but in Vegas, they're really a lot more stupid. It's the Trooper. It's Sunday. It's 4:41, later than it should be. Boosted board sitting right there going, Trooper, why don't you take me out? Why don't we go out today? No, not today. Boosted board has not enough time. But soon. Soon, little fella. At least a few days since I've been here suffering withdrawals. Not here for lunch, just here for something for later and for tomorrow morning. Now, got to. I mean, I'm gonna go get pizza at Pinup Pizza, but you gotta have, this is some kind of coconut strudel. Man, I gotta tell you, you got to go to 85 degrees. Man, that's the best. Oh man, that good. Oh man, coconut? Believe me, they're not paying me to say this. That's on our list because, I don't know, it's a bakery in Chinatown. So it's on the list. Oh, snap. You know, I don't believe in it, but what if I'm wrong? You ain't got to believe in it. If it's real, you don't have to believe in it. I don't believe in it, but what if I'm wrong? So apparently Planet Hollywood has a situation that's somewhat similar to Westgate with the free roll in the tournament, and I only need like an hour and 15 minutes to get it. Conservatory action going. All right, I'm gonna pass through Bellagio just to take a peek at the poker room, just to see if anything's different. As you can see, there's still plexiglass in the pits at Bellagio. Just noting it as we walk through.
probably in the poker room too, if that's the case. So we'll take a peek just for fun. As you can see, plexiglass still up in Bellagio poker room. Somebody said on Twitter June 1st to get rid of the plexiglass. I don't know where they get that from. Maybe they got it from a reliable source. Maybe they did it. Who knows?
What up, Pete Francis from I fucked that up.
What's up, Pete?
What up, Pete? Scottsdale Saint, what's up? Trooper's the man. Thank you so much.
Oh, thanks, Pete, for watching the videos.
Of course, dude.
First time I'm seeing that Starbucks open since COVID started. Need to, but they let you get two because it's up to $20. So I got two margarita and big meat action. I said big meat action. I'm super pleased to report that the pinup pizza was like 5 times better than the last couple times I had it. I don't know why. It was really good though. The margarita was good, but it's a little too wet. You know? All right, let's go see if we can get in a game. I think I just invented a new thing, but I have to credit the name of it to Robert in my game. Shout out to Robert. I raised with ace queen. The flop was a whiff, but I decided to c-bet. It was heads up, and the game is playing a little bit on the tight side. The guy check raised and then showed me 10-5 of spades. It was jack 4-3, two spades. So he shows me that he just had a flush draw. All right. Very next hand, I raise. It's that guy's big blind. I raise to 10 with 9-10 of hearts. And the guy 3-bet pre-flop to 30. So I put 20 more in. And the flop was king 10-9. And he checked. So I had 138 in my stack at that point. So I picked up 135 in one tall stack with one hand, and I lifted it up and gestured as if I was going to put it in the pot, but I stopped and looked at the guy, and then I put the 135 down in the pot. So he called. Well, I have $3 behind. So the turn was some kind of blank, like a five. He checked and I bet $2. And the river was a deuce. And he checked and I bet $1. And he called. So, Robert called it a troll bet. I think that's funny. I feel kind of dickish in a way. But like, why you gotta brag on the 10-5 of spades, bro? You know what I'm saying? Like, keep your 10-5 of spades to yourself next time. I just think it was funny. So that is now going to be known as the troll. Oh, by the way, I won the pot. He had ace king. I guess I should mention that I won. So from now on, that is called the troll bet. Coffee time. Good game, but I really want a coffee. The Starbucks at Planet Hollywood is pure trash. What is the point of all that shit? The Starbucks at Planet Hollywood is pure trash. I get shitty attitudes from behind the counter, and the coffee sucks every single time. An Americano should taste like an Americano at every single Starbucks all the time, and it doesn't. The one from Planet Hollywood tastes like burnt shit. I would love to be able to go over to the Starbucks at Cosmo, but I don't think it's open. It's 11 p.m., so I'm just taking a walk. It looks like there's gonna be no coffee for me. Maybe a little walk over the bridge, in the breeze, or gale force winds, whatever this is. Maybe that'll make me feel a little better. Make me feel like trying to battle it out for at least another hour. As suspected. And with that, it's about 1 a.m. at Planet Hollywood, where basically the only pot I won, I think, is the one that I told you about already. The rest of the night is just never ever having a hand. At least tonight I managed to lose 20 here, 30 there, and I'm only down 195 for the night. But what a brutal session again. I hate it when they come back to back. Sometimes the good ones come back to back to back to back, and then the bad ones come back to back. I don't feel as good after a good one as I feel bad after a bad one. Is that weird? I mean, I don't feel that bad, but just discouraged. And whatever, it is what it is. Still on the winning side of things overall. I guess if you won every night, it wouldn't be exciting. It wouldn't be fun. I got pretty bored in there. And just every single hand I raised, I got nothing. I got nothing going, and I got people in that game that will not fold. They just will not fold. So it's like you either make a hand or you lose the money you put in the pot. But there's always tomorrow. At least at this point, there's always tomorrow. Yo, that's gonna be the end of Sunday. I'm gonna go home and try to get some sleep. I was up super late last night. Slept too late again today. My schedule, once my sleep schedule shifts, it's hard for me to get it back on. It feels so nice out here. It feels terrible with the mask on right now because it's getting warmer outside. Walking around, even inside with the mask on, when you come out and take the mask off, it feels amazing. This breeze action we got going tonight. I hope they get rid of this dumbass mask mandate bullshit soon. I said it. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.